Another distinct way we can remember information is through schemas. We can define schemas as a mental framework that develops from our experiences with particular people, objects, or events. That is, you can think of schemas as framework for representing some aspects of the world that tells us how people, objects, or events are most likely to look like or act like. Schemas influence our attention and the absorption of new knowledge. In fact, we're more likely to notice things that fit into our schema once we have a schema formed. So they help us to understand and organize experiences. They can also aid in our memory and recall. However, it's important to note that schemas have a tendency to remain unchanged even if we're presented with new information that contradicts our schema. Let's say you have a schema of a college professor. That is, you have a conceptual idea of what a professor looks like. Perhaps if they're a man or a woman, how old they are, how tall they are, or how they dress. So it may be that someone's schema for a professor is that they're old, they wear sports jackets with patches in the elbows, they have glasses, they carry a briefcase, they're male, and other identifying features of a professor. So if that's a person's schema for a professor, research shows that if he or she is presented with new information that is contradictory of that schema, for example, it being a young woman who dresses rather casually, carrying a backpack rather than a briefcase, and so on, the person with the developed schema would be less likely to remember the female professor. So schemas can aid in our ability to remember, but they also bias our memory and our perception.